I'm going to start reading in verse number one, and I'm just going to give you what God gave me. Two men actually confirmed this. The Lord had been dealing with me about preaching this yesterday, laid this on my heart, and I was just trying to pray and seek the Lord's face. And two different men made a comment, and I told one of them, I said, "You just confirmed what the Lord wants me to preach." And I'm glad when God does that. God knows what we need. I don't know why God had laid this on my heart. I don't. But I'm gonna do my best just to get myself out of the way and let God use me tonight. Genesis chapter 3 and verse number 1. Bible said, "Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, Yea, hath God said, Ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, Ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, Ye shall not surely die. For God doth know that in the day that ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil." And that's all I'm going to read. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we come before you, Lord, one more time, God, this evening. And we thank you, God, for this heaven-bought privilege, God, that you've given us here to, Lord, to assemble ourselves in your house. And I pray, God, tonight that you'd just let us come together, one accord and one mind. I pray, God, that you'd let me now. God, open my mouth, and God, that you'd fill it. Lord, we need it. We need to hear, God, from heaven, Lord. We so desperately need your word, God, today. Lord, in the air in which we live, God, we know that we need the truth more than anything in this world. So, God, I pray you'd anoint me now, God, and you'd open our hearts now, Lord, to receive your word. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray, and amen. Now, the Bible said that the devil here, brother, come to Eve in the garden. Amen. As we all know the story, amen, he come up there, amen, as the most subtle beast, amen, of the field. And amen, the Bible said now, amen, that as the devil came, amen, and began to, amen, talk to Eve, and that he came as that serpent, amen. And the Bible said, amen, now David said, amen, that, amen, he walks through at the valley of the shadow of death, and that he'd fear no evil. And well, you see, David, amen, knew, amen, who our brother was leading him. But Eve in this day, our brother, she is led away by the subtlety of, amen, the devil. But David also said, our brother, in Psalm 23, he said, "The Lord, amen, is my shepherd, I shall not want. Amen, he makes me to lie down in green, amen, pastures tonight." Amen, if you'd have it now, when God saved us, amen, he put us in the green pastures. Amen, God has led us, our friend, laid down, amen, in green pastures, as the song says, and so full and so sweet, and God leads his dear children along. And well, he's let me lay down, our friend, here with him in the green pasture, which is the house of God. But friend, the thought that God had laid on my heart, amen, was a snake, amen, in the grass. And now we've all, amen, I heard that statement from time to time. Amen, we've heard somebody say, "Well, oh, so and so, they're just a snake in the grass." That means you can't tell, brother, what they are. But they're just there waiting on you. I'm ready to reach out and bite you. I'm ready to catch you. I'm friend, when you're unaware, well, that's what the devil is. But you know the devil, brother, he's got his ministers. Amen, he's got his ones that he'll sit down, friend, right in the church house, and he'll try to lead, amen, men and women astray. And I don't know, I done told you, I don't know why God had laid this on my heart. hard. How about you pray for me? I'm going to try to give you what God give me. How about now when God called me? I'm brother to pastor this church. I friend he may put me. I'm an over you. And amen, you know what he told me? He said, you're, amen, the under shepherd. And now see, I'm not the shepherd. And Jesus is the shepherd. But while I'm here, amen, God's put you. Brother, amen, he's made me accountable for what comes in this church. He's made me accountable for your spiritual health. And you see, not just anybody is going to get up and preach. And not just anybody is going to get up and amen. Amen, preach the word of God. It's going to be somebody that's got the anointing of God. And you say, preacher, why does it really matter? Because your souls, friend, are hanging in the balance. There's been some come. And friend, they said they're going to start. Amen, one preacher told me, amen, said I'm going to come every Wednesday. Amen, every Sunday night. Because I need to be fed. Well, when he found out that he wasn't going to preach every other time, then where they at right now? Friend, you know what they are? Amen, some people now, they're not in it for the truth. They don't want to be fed. It's all about their name. It's all about who they are. But it don't matter if you ever know my name, if the world knows who I am or not. It's all about Jesus. It's all about him. But that's all that really matters. Our friend in this life, amen, have the devil come into you, have the garden that day, have just an old serpent, have brother hiding in the grass. Amen, that's what he is right now. I wonder how many churches, our friend, when you look around, amen, you look and see, amen, how many have sitting right on the pew, and that, amen, they're just snakes, have brother hiding in the grass, and that's all that they are. And you've seen them come in. And maybe, amen, I don't believe that we've got them in this church. Amen, I really don't. But amen, you rest assured that, amen, as long as God is a moving in our lives, as long as God is a moving in this church, then the devil's going to send them in. I don't know how long it'll take, but the devil's going to send them in. The devil's send that one in. That buddy's up with this one. And buddy's up with that one. And says, oh, so-and-so, have they been talking about you? Have they been running you down? You better beware. Amen, of that devil. You better beware. Have that one that leads you astray. Friend, they're out there. They're out there. Have the one that sits beside of you. That could be the very snake in the grass tonight. Amen, they come in. Amen, sit right down in the pew. Amen, all they're there for is to cause trouble. Amen, a man tell me, amen, last night, and he said, amen, there's this pastor. And then he got up and he said, I've got to tell the church. And the piano player's sitting at the piano. And he said, I've had an affair with the piano player. And amen, he said, I've got to come up, amen. I come clean on it. And that's what he told him. Amen, but it turns out, and I'm not taking the blame, amen, off the pastor, don't take me wrong. But it turns out that woman, that she went church to church, brother, amen, and she'd lead one away, and she'd lead another away. You know what that is? That's a snake in the grass. That's a snake in the grass. Friend, you, amen, I've seen them. They come in the church. Amen, you say it don't matter how we dress. Amen, oh yes it does. It don't matter how we live. Oh yes it does. It don't matter what we do, what we say. Amen, oh yes it does. Friend, they come in the house of God. Amen, they sit right down the pew. And all they've got on their mind, and the whole time that they're there, is what they can tear up next. What they can tear up next. Amen, we got them, amen. And they're in churches everywhere. And sooner or later, no doubt the devil, he's going to send them here. But we've got to put up a guard. I don't know why God, I would lay this on my heart. But you rest assured that the devil, he's going to be coming for everybody that lives for God. He's going to be coming for you if you live for the Lord tonight. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I wonder, amen, how Eve felt when the devil, amen, said, now God lied to you. You ain't going to die. You ain't going to die. Amen and amen. The very day that she ate, and the very day that Adam ate the fruit, that death came upon all men. Amen. The very day that Adam ate the fruit, and when Adam died, that was that old snake in the grass. Amen. You say he wasn't a snake in. Amen. I know he had legs. But brother, you know what I'm saying. Amen. There's an amen snake in the grass. I'll come up and get you. Amen. Hide right in among the sheep. Amen. Hide right in among. Amen. Amen. That's why tonight. Amen. Oh, it sickens me. Had to think about, amen, all these stories. How about how somebody gets right in the youth group? How about how somebody gets right to teaching Sunday school? And it ain't just a Catholic church. Friend, it's in our churches around here. How about, amen, these sexual predators? Amen. They come in there and they get these young women. Amen. These young girls. And they get, amen, get to, amen. How they get their phone numbers. Amen. They get, amen, they get on Snapchat. Chad, amen, I'm going to tell you, do you all good. Amen, amen, I'm not a preacher against brother social media. But I know what I had Snapchat for when I was a lost man. I know what I had it for. It's because I knew what a sin that nobody could, amen. It's going to be deleted when it got there. That nobody could save it. Amen, let me tell you tonight how this devil's a snake in the grass. Amen, there's people out there that's after your soul. And there's people out there that want to deceive you and take your eyes off God. How you better be careful of them snakes in the grass. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Bible said, amen, and Aaron had two sons, had Nadab and Abihu. Amen. And one day, they began to offer fire. Had they got them some incense in a plate. And they began to burn it. And the Bible said they offered a strange fire unto the Lord. And do you know what God did? God sent down the fire. And the fire devoured up, amen, Nadab and Abihu. And Moses said, Aaron, amen, them that do this, I mean, them that offer up fire, they've got to be right with the Lord. You see, they can put on the gay clothing. And amen, they can put on the nice apparel. Amen, they can put on the tie. They can put on the pretty dress. But inside the ravening wolves. Amen. Inside the ravening wolves. Amen. I don't understand why. Amen. That God sent me this way. Amen. This message this night. But God will never. Amen. His word will never. Return unto him void. God's got a reason. God's got a reason. God's got a reason. For every message that's preached. Friends, you better. Beware of them snakes. That's a hiding in the grass. Amen. Amen. It kills me. I mean, it breaks my heart to see the black eyes been put on the church by the devil. Amen. Amen. I mean, people's afraid to send their kids to church. Amen. Because of what might go on in the Sunday school class. Amen. People's afraid. Amen. You can't have youth group trips. Amen. Because you don't know. Amen. You can't send your youngins to camp no more. Because of my, amen, you don't know what's going to happen. When they get down there. Amen. The devil's in there, ain't he? The devil's in there. It ain't everybody that says, Lord, Lord, that's going to heaven. It ain't everybody that says, Lord, Lord, that's really got it. It ain't everybody that carries a Bible. Amen. That's amen, man of God. It ain't everybody that sings. Amen. That's got the Lord in their heart. It ain't everybody that, amen, releases a gospel album. That's got the Lord down their heart. There's people out there. Amen. They're unstable souls. They want to beguile you and lead you away from the truth. The Bible said, having eyes full of adultery, they cannot cease from sin. Amen. Oh, yeah. That's where we're at right now. Have the snakes, amen. Have it'll come right in the church. Have get right down the grass. And they're just waiting. Have to grab a hold of somebody. Amen. Amen. You get, amen. The Bible said, know them that labor among you. Amen. It ain't everybody. Amen. That comes in, sits down in the pew, and raises their hand, Robert. That's right with God. It ain't everybody. Amen. That's why.
Amen. You just want to know who's got it. Amen. They won't come for a month and quit. Amen. Amen. They won't be in the, amen, in here and then out there and in here and then out there. Amen. Amen. You see it all the time. How they come and they pray. They've been saved 42 times. Amen. They get on the altar every time there's a revival. Amen. But amen, they don't gain got nothing. That's going to stick it out. Amen. But they come in, they leave everybody else. Amen. Amen. They talk about, amen, you better be weary of them. That's left that church down yonder. Amen. I'm not, amen. You say, well, who you preaching to? I'm just preaching what God give me. You better be weary of them. That leave that church up the road. Brother, amen, 50 of them at a time. And go to the next church. I'm going to tell you what they are. They're just snakes in the grass. And they're waiting to catch your soul. Amen. Amen. That's what they're waiting on. The Bible said, and when Nadab and Abihu offered up strange fire, I bet you they had the priest garments on. I bet they looked the part. Amen. I bet they, amen, them Catholic priests, amen, they wear the white collar. Amen. They get in there. Amen. They put on the good show. And they get in there in that little room. Amen. They confess what they've been doing. Amen. Then they, amen, they get in there. Amen. I've heard stories. Amen. Of these young girls. Amen. Amen. It's been led away by them. Amen. Been taken advantage of by them. But it's going on right now. I bet it's shocking right now. What's going on in Scott County? Amen. People that claim to be youth leaders. People that claim to be pastors. But the devil's got his crowd. The Bible said no marvel. That Satan himself has transformed into, amen, an angel of light. Amen. You know they're out there. You know they're out there. And let me say this one thing. Amen. 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 And when that man comes in and he's got his eyes on some other woman that ain't his wife, you better watch that man. And when that woman comes in and she's got her dress cut down to here, you better watch that woman. Amen. Hallelujah. I know that ain't popular preaching, but you know it's right. Amen. The devil, amen, he's got his ministers out there. And they look apart. And they look real good. But amen, they sit right down the pew. And all they've got on their mind is causing trouble in the house of God. Amen. That's how churches get broken up. Amen. That's how pastors get discouraged. That's how deacons get discouraged and quit. Amen. Because of snakes right in the grass. Amen. You can't see it, Eugene. When it's down there, amen, the grass is tall. Amen, but you know what's going to, amen, show it. Amen, when that two-edged sword, Robert, starts cutting that grass down. Amen, then you can see the snake. Amen, amen. You know why they get in churches? And friend, amen, they never found out. Because half our preachers, they don't preach against nothing. Amen, amen. Amen, half our preachers, they ain't got enough backbone, brother, to stand against anything. But if the Bible's against it, then I'm against it. Amen, it don't matter if you do it. It don't matter if everybody, amen, if every last one of you, I leaves here tonight mad at me, I'll still preach the truth. I'll still stand on the Bible. Amen, you say, preacher, amen, why in the world? Amen, amen. Why in the world? How would you preach that? Because God gave it to me. And friend, that's all I know to preach. That's all I know to preach. But you rest assured, amen, the devil, amen, God's trying to warn you. Because the devil, he's after your soul. Amen. I don't know when the devil come in. Amen, but the devil's going to. Amen, he's going to. Amen. He'll sit down. Amen. You remember, Robert, what you told me a few weeks ago? It ain't going to come from where you thought it's going to. See, amen, it'll be them ones you don't expect it. Amen, them ones that everybody, amen, I mean, they've been going to church for 30 years. I mean, they taught Sunday school here. They taught Sunday school there. Amen. There's a deacon down the road. Amen, there's a deacon here. Well, let me just say, why in the world, amen, ain't they still a deacon there? Amen, why in the world? Amen, you see, sooner or later when you fall out with everybody, it's time to look in the mirror and say, maybe it ain't everybody else. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm the problem. Amen, they're snaking the grass. And friend, they don't even know it. But they get in here in the day. devil uses them. And the devil, amen. And the devil begins to work. I'm going to tell you what the devil would like to do. He'd like to take every one of us and shut the doors and keep us at the house. And amen. So we'd backslide and grow cold on God. Amen. Amen. That's why, amen, the devil, he ain't a working with the lost crowd. He don't care if they keep her wife all their life. But I'm gonna tell you what he wants to do in the church. He wants this one to run off with that one. Amen. Wants this one, run off with that one. That's what the devil wants. Amen. And amen. I know a church. Amen. A good friend of mine pastors it. Amen. And he, amen, what, too many years ago, there was this couple that's married. I mean, Nathan, they went on vacation together. They did everything together. Right in the house of God. Amen. But amen. Then it comes out years down the road. Amen. Amen. This one, I was sleeping with that one's wife. Amen. That's the devil. That's a snake in the grass. And I wonder how many, amen, I wonder how many, amen, has been led away and won't go to church because they heard that happen at the house of God. Amen. Amen. It's a sad thing. Amen. When the snake gets in there in the grass. Amen. And all he's after. Well, you know what the thief's after, don't you? To steal, to kill, and to destroy. Hey, you better take heed tonight. Amen. Because the devil, he'll try. You know where he'll go to? He'll go to the one that says, I don't have to listen to that because it'll never happen to me. And the devil, okay, it might not be adultery. It might not be lust for you. But the devil will try to break up. He'll try to break up your spiritual life. Amen. Any way he can do it. Amen. If he can get you to lay out of church. Amen. If he can get you involved in the world. If he can get you to, amen, put things before God, he'll do it. You better beware of that snake that's hiding. He's hiding right there in the grass. Amen. He's right there beside of you. Amen. What are you going to do? You better run to God before he grabs a hold of you. Amen. Amen. They beguile unstable souls, the Bible said. And the Bible said, amen, that when the devil come to Eve, he put one word in there. Thou, she said, you will not surely die. See, if your Bible don't read like mine, you got the wrong one. You will not surely die. That's what he told her. One word. One word. Let me tell you what the devil did. Amen. He got a bunch together there in the late 70s. And he said, let's make us a new Bible. Amen. Let's make us. Amen. We'll call it the New International Version. How'd you know there's two homosexuals on it? I mean, there's two homosexuals. Amen. On that translating team. I mean, come out and said this right. Amen. Said this in that shape. I've claimed to be right. I mean, the devil's got them out there. He's got them out there. He's deceived so many. And so many are deceived themselves. And let me tell you why. That men and women can shack up and think they're right with God because there's been snakes that's come right in the church house, and there's been serpents that's come right in the church house, and they turned men and women away from wanting the truth, and now their hearts have been turned to fables. Amen. Amen. There's a snake in the grass. And amen. He might not be at Valley View yet, but he's coming. He's coming. I don't know what he's going to get you with. I don't know what he's going to try to get me with. Amen. But it might be. Amen. The devil might tell you. It'd be all right if you don't go on Wednesdays no more. Amen. I told some of them that this week. It'd be all right if you don't go on Wednesdays no more. That turns into Sunday night. Amen. That turns into Sunday morning. And then the only time you go is Easter. Amen. Then the only time you go is Christmas. The only time you go is Mother's Day. Amen. I've heard of many. Amen. All they go to church for is to please a mommy. Amen. All they go to church for is to please everybody else. You better not come to please me. But you better come to worship God. You better not come to please me. But you better come to please the Lord. Amen. You better be wary. You better watch out for that devil. You better watch out for that one that'll creep right in and sit right down beside of you and lead you astray. Amen. Amen. You know, you've seen it happen. I mean, it's happened at this church and that church. Heard stories of it happening here years ago. The devil will do it if you'll let him do it. Amen. Snake in the grass. Amen. You know who's a snake in the grass? The Bible said that Jesus chose 12. And he said, one of you is a devil. He went with the Lord everywhere, Eugene. He seen the blind man healed. He seen the dumb man begin to talk. He seen the lame man run through the man begin to walk. He seen all these things. He seen Jesus come a walking on the water. They was out there in the boat one night. They's all afraid. The Bible said they looked out yonder and they thought that he was a spirit. But they said, amen. Peter said, Lord, if it's you, bid me come. He said, just come on out here, Peter. He began to walk. All the time, Judas sitting right back there, seeing the power of God. And all the time, the devil just awaiting. Oh, I've got my chance. I'm going to get in that man. I'm going to use that man. I'm going to use him to tear it down what God's building up. But oh no, the devil can only do so much. You see, he might ruin you. He might take you out of the house of God. But he'll never do away with the church. He'll never do away with the Lamb of God. God's going to have a remnant. God's going to have a remnant. I want to ask you right now, are you going to be part of it when the last day comes? Amen. Amen. Where are you going to stand at? Amen. Judgment. Amen. There's going to be some. Nathan, they stand before God in judgment. Amen. For things that they did in the church house to lead people astray. Amen. People get up. Amen. They teach us this false, rotten doctrine that says it don't matter how you live. You show me that in the Bible, I believe it. But it ain't in there. Amen. Amen. If you die a sinner, you're going to get up one. Amen. If you die in sin, you'll get up in sin. If you die a drunkard, amen, you'll get up a drunkard. If you die, amen, die hooked on dope, you get up hooked on dope. Amen. Amen. You say, preacher, it ain't about works. I know that it ain't. But when somebody gets right with God, their works will follow after them. Amen. Amen. God makes a change, don't he? Amen. But the snake says, that snake in the grass to get right down the church says, well, amen, we've got all this education. We've read after all these good men. We've read this commentary. Amen. We've read this one, read that one. Amen. I'm going to tell you. Amen. I ain't against that. Amen. But I'm leery who I read after, because I don't know how in the world how they lived. I have no idea what kind of life they lived. Amen. But them that get up, I know how they live. Amen. They might not be as educated. But hallelujah, if they get the power of God, I say, just give me Jesus. Amen. The Bible said that Peter and John, they's ignorant and unlearned. But they looked at them men and they said, they've been with Jesus. Have they been with Jesus? As you might not have what the world says you should have. As you might not have. Amen. The Bible knowledge of some man. Amen. That's got a amen degree. But if you've been with Jesus and you'll read your Bible, God will open your heart. God will teach you. He'll lead you and he'll guide you into all truth. Amen. You watch out for that man that's got everything figured out. I ain't got everything figured out. Amen. I don't. Amen. But you watch out for that man tells you he does. You watch out for that man says, I know everything. Amen. You can't teach me nothing. Amen. If that's the case, with all, amen, you'd done be in heaven. Amen. That preacher says that, if that's the case, he wouldn't be here no more. Amen. Amen. It's growing to be over with. But as long as we're here, we're going to grow. As long as we're here, that's why it's so important. And to watch out for that one. And to sneak in right beside of you and lead your soul away from God. Amen. So, Judas walked with God. He started out, seemed like he's just one of them, didn't he? He probably wore the clothing they did, went the places they did. Amen. Ate the food they ate. He looked apart, didn't he? You couldn't tell him apart, like him wheat and them tires. Amen. Looked apart. Amen. Went to the synagogue on the Sabbath. Amen. Followed Jesus down there and heard him preach. When Jesus was in there and he turned over the tables, Judas was probably right there saying, amen. Amen. Bless him, Lord. Judas was right there. But I've heard men, amen, their own condemnation. I preached against worldly music. And let me say this. When I say worldly music, maybe maybe you heard, amen, you misunderstand me. Amen, I'm not saying, amen, I'm not preaching against, amen, say amen, amen, some new thing. Amen, now there's some of it I'll listen to. But I'm not necessarily preaching against something, amen, amen, on 106.9. Amen, amen, that can be bad, it can. Amen, amen, if it's got the devil in it, no doubt it can. But when I say worldly music, amen, I mean you, Alan Jackson. Amen, I mean you, George Jones. When I say worldly music, amen, oh yeah, everybody's against AC/DC. Amen, but when George Jones is just singing about how sorry he is, amen, because his wife went off and left him, where in the world do you think your joy is at? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Just give me something that makes me want to go home. Just give me something that makes me want to go home. Amen. Just give me something that says, victory in Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that one Sunday morning, God plunged me beneath that crimson flow. And when I got up, I laid hold on the victory. Amen. Amen. But you better watch them snakes in the grass. It says, well, a little bit won't hurt you. A little leaven. Leaven with a whole lump. Amen. See, when I first got saved, God began to deal with me. Amen. There's things I quit. Still things. And amen. There'll be things God probably tells me to lay down tomorrow. I mean, I'm growing in this thing. Amen. I laid down. Amen. Amen, amen. You know what I found out? Somebody told me one time. Amen. He said, amen, this man told me. He said, now, amen, getting close to God, amen, ain't giving things up. Amen. Well, that's funny because, amen, that's how I've got close to God. Amen. When he told me to lay it down, I know, amen, I'm far from where I want to be. I'd love to be closer. But, amen, to get where I'm at right now, I've had to give things up when God said, lay them down. Amen. Them snakes in the grass nowadays say it don't matter what you do. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. Amen. Judas, he walked with the Lord. Amen. The treasure. I mean the treasure. Amen. Amen. The treasure. Carried the money bag around. Amen. But you know what he was the whole time? He's a snake in the grass. He's a snake in the grass. Amen. Them people. Amen. Just come on back here. That's what they say. Amen. Just they start grooming them little, amen, 8 year, 8, 9 year old girls. Amen. Amen. 8, 9 year old boys. Start grooming them. Amen. The devil puts them in the church. Amen. Amen. See, when somebody comes in and says, I want to teach Sunday school, but we ain't never seen them before, that ought to be a red flag. But churches in our day, they put it out, amen, in the classifieds like it's a job. I mean, that ain't the way it works. I mean, God's going to send you to do it. God's going to send you to do it. God's going to be the one that puts you in that place. Amen. Amen. Snake in the grass. Amen. I've seen them. They visit every hospital. When somebody's sick, they're there. Amen. But the whole time, they're looking for unstable souls, trying to grab them, trying to take them away from God. Like I said, it ain't everybody that carries a Bible. Amen. I've heard people preach funerals that said they's right. Amen. That said so and so died and went to heaven. I don't know whether they did or not. But if they died drunk in a car wreck, I sure ain't going to say they did. Amen. I sure ain't going to say they did. I've heard people preach funerals. Amen. And amen. That person lived like hell all their life. Well, so-and-so's over there now. Amen. Maybe they didn't make things right. But if they didn't leave a testimony, amen, I ain't going to get up and say they did. Amen. I ain't going to get up and say they did. That's why, amen, I don't much mind it. Having somebody I don't know that says, I want you to preach this funeral. They can't expect me to say nothing good. I'll just preach the Bible. Amen. 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 Oh, you've heard me tell it before. But there was a man that's a leader. Amen. Down at a church in Weber City. One of them old lukewarm churches. One of them old loose churches. That says it don't matter how you dress. Now if you're lost, amen, come in here, it don't matter. Amen. God will clean you up. But if you've been saved for 30 years and the preacher still has to tell you how you ought to dress, there's something wrong with you. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. It don't matter. Come as you are. Yeah, that's right. But don't leave the same way. Amen. Come a sinner. But if God gets a hold of you, He'll make a change in you. Amen. But I heard he's over there with Eugene. They didn't think nobody knew. He's over there just buddied up, and he said, well, you thinking men would have said something good about her. I thought, buddy, I don't even know who she is. I mean, what in the world am I supposed to say about her? I mean, I just preach the Bible. Amen. What in the world? Amen. I mean, people, amen, they're looking for fairy tales. But fairy tales ain't going to get the generation under us to heaven. Fairy tales ain't going to get us closer to God. Fairy tales, amen, might make you feel good. But when we get the knots burned off of us, and when we get to where we need to be with God, the Word of God will make you shout hallelujah. It'll make you feel better than anything the world ever give you. Amen. I know everybody in a shouter. Amen. But it'll do something for you. It'll do something for you. You better be weary or leery of them snakes in the grass. You better be leery of them. A snake, they can get in some pretty crazy places. I mean, I've seen pictures on the internet of them getting in toilets. Amen. Getting in people's cars. Amen. And I remember I was a kid. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. I was a kid and we had a bird cage. We'd never had a bird, but for some reason there was a bird cage. It had been at somebody else's house. Amen. And my mother brought it home, put it in the garage. And I was down there and just playing outside. And I went in the garage and there was a snake in that bird cage. I guess where, amen, a bird been in there before. Amen. And I went up, and at first I didn't think it was real. And I looked at it and it moved. And I went up there and I told my mom and dad, and I said, there's a snake down there. Amen. In the bird cage. Amen. They didn't believe me. I thought I was playing a joke on them. They thought I put some rubber snake down there. Ain't that the way it is now? When the preacher says you better watch out, ain't nobody believes him. Amen. When the preacher says you better be leery, they say, oh no, preacher, I'll take time and I can handle it. I can handle it. You can't handle it if you can, amen, if so-and-so, as so-and-so has been led away from God, if they can handle it. Ask them pastors that quit and ain't been back to church since, if they can handle it. Amen. You know what a snake in the grass does? It causes discord. It causes discord. Amen. There's been so many pastors, and I'm getting very close, that's been discouraged and quit because there's been so much discord in church. Amen. We want to come to this one and say, Pastor, listen, come here. Listen, what so-and-so said to me. Amen. Listen. Amen. Some of you do you good to tame his tongue. Amen. Amen. Some of you do you good. Thankful you say something. Some of you do you good. Amen. The Bible said that the tongue is a fire. And oh, what a matter. A little flame kindleth. It'll set the woods on fire. It'll set the world on fire. Amen. How many skilled their brother have with this tongue that's a hiding behind their teeth. Amen. Praise the Lord. It'd do us all good if we tame his tongue. Amen. If we'd say amen, maybe think a little more before we said something. Amen. People say something, hurt people's feelings, and ain't no sense in it. Amen. Now, if it's the truth, say it. Amen. But if you say something that shouldn't be said, amen, and God ain't in it, amen, you call somebody to leave the church, and you've got blood on your hands. Amen. Now, if it's the truth, praise God, say it. Amen. If it's the Bible, say it. And when we go tell it, when you got to go behind closed doors and say it, it probably ain't the truth. Right. Amen. When you got to pull somebody to the side and say it, it probably ain't the truth. Praise the like that good preaching. When you got to go behind the door and tell somebody and you're afraid everybody else hear it. Right. Amen. It probably ain't something you ought to be saying. Right. Amen. Oh me, I've said things I shouldn't have said. Amen. I've been told things I thought was right because the man that told me, I thought he was telling me right. But I should have never said it. I should have never repeated it. I saw it with my own eyes. Amen. Been guilty. Oh me. Amen. Oh me. I've been there. Amen. That's a snake in the grass. He'll slither right up. You know where he'll get? He'll get on the altar, Robert. Amen. He'll get on the altar. And you know what he says? He says, y'all don't need to use the altar. Y'all sanctified. Y'all are holy. And the devil just sits up here and says, y'all don't need it. He sits in your pew and he says, you don't need it. Amen. He slithered right up in the grass that God's made you lay down in. And just like he beguiled Eve, he'll beguile you. He'll beguile me. He'll get every one of us if he can. Amen. He'll get every one of us if he can. But you better be on the lookout for that silver-tongued devil. Comes and promises you liberty. Amen. But he himself is a servant of corruption. Old Judas walked with Jesus. Amen. And they got out there. Amen. Here come the time. Amen. When a little money got on the table. Ain't that the way it is? Amen. People preach the truth till a little money gets in on the table. Amen. People will preach the gospel. Amen. Or people will stand for the truth. Amen. People will stand for this, stand for that. Amen. Until a little money gets on the table. Amen. There's been pastors that's backed up because they thought they was losing the crowd. Amen. Amen. Because that's where their livelihood was at. There's been pastors that's backed up because they thought they was going to lose that offering they was getting. Amen. I'd rather have a few have that wants the truth, have that 200, have that can't handle it. I'd rather have a few have that knows how to praise God. Now, don't get me wrong. I want the house have to be filled with the lost person. But I'd rather have a few saints of God have that 200 lukewarm, have that don't know want no more of God, have that all they're doing is listening to the devil every day. Amen. Amen. You know what hinders the service? Let the devil slither right up to you and listen to him. Amen. Judas walked with him. Amen. And Judas one day, he said, all right. See, over in Psalms, it said, my own familiar friend that I've eat bread with has lifted up his heel against me. Has a prophesying of Judas. My own familiar friend. I believe David could have been talking about Saul too. But he's also talking about, amen, he's also prophesying what Judas would do. My own familiar friend. I ate bread with him. Amen, I wonder how many of you can say, my own familiar friend that I sat in the house of God with, and now they won't talk to me. Amen, my own familiar friend. I used to do this with. Amen, now when the truth come down, how they don't want nothing to do with me no more. Amen, my own familiar friend had that ate from God's table, and now they don't want the truth. And now they backslid on God. And now they're out there in the world. We've all seen it. We've all seen it. But if you ain't careful, it'll be you. Amen. It'll be you. Amen. The Bible said that Judas went up and he said, how much will you give me for him? If I bring Jesus to you, what will you give me? He said, here's 30 pieces of silver. And he went out and he said, all right. Amen. I'll tell you where he's going to be. He's out there in the Garden of Gethsemane. And here he come. Amen. Come in there at night and they come with staves. Amen. They come like he's going to go get a thief. And he kissed the Lord on the cheek. And the Lord looked at him and said, Judas, betrayest thou me with a kiss? Amen. He said, amen. You know what the Lord did? The Lord looked at him. He said, I'm he. And they all fell down. When the power of God, you can't hide the power of God. Amen. You might roll around and act like you got it. Amen. But when it really falls, you'll know who's got it. Amen. When the power of God really gets so thick, I love to see it. Like it was in Moses' day. You say, preacher, we can't have it like that. You quit believing the devil. You quit believing the devil. We can still have the power of God if we quit listening to that devil. Amen. 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 He's a liar. He's a liar from the beginning. That's all he does, lie. And the Bible said they led him up there and they killed him and crucified him. And Judas comes in there and he says, I don't want this money. He was convicted, but it's too late. I don't want this money. Y'all take it back. Can you imagine the shame he had on him? Knowing he just betrayed the Son of God. He said, I don't want this money. I can just see him now. What have I done now? What have I done now? Amen. He said, I don't want this money. And they said, that ain't no good to us. That's blood money. You see thou to it. You take it. You take it. And he took it out there and he cast it in the field. Amen. Amen. The Bible said it's blood money, and that's where he put it. Amen. In the field of blood. Amen. He went out there and he hung himself. And the Bible said he fell headlong and his bowels gushed out and he went to his own place. Amen. You know what his place was? Hell. Hell. The Bible said, and I'm closing. Amen. And there was a man named Bar-Jesus. He was a false prophet. And when Paul came out to her, and amen, there was a man, Sergius, I believe his name was, a prudent man that wanted to hear the word of God. And boy, Jesus said, no. Amen, amen. He don't need to hear the word of God. Amen. I've seen them in my life too. Amen. And if they didn't get right with God, they'll die and go to hell. Because of making other people die and go to hell. Amen. But he said, oh, you know what Paul said? He said, oh, thou full of all subtlety, thou child of the devil. Amen. You know what comes in the house of God? When the snakes in the grass. And those children of the devil that'll sit right down in the pew beside of you. Amen. I don't know when they're going to come. Amen. But sooner or later, the devil, he'll get somebody. And if you ain't careful, he'll pull you astray. The Bible said Dinah, the daughter that Jacob had, amen, went out one day to look at the inhabitants of the land, see all the other daughters. She's just being friendly. Amen, she's just going out there. And one man of the inhabitants of the land thought she's a pretty good looking woman. He said, I'd like to have her for myself. And the Bible said that all the boys there, they said, no, unless you be circumcised, you can't have her. We can't give our sister to somebody that ain't got the mark that God said Abraham would have. Amen. But all the time, they knew they weren't going to give Dinah to him. They knew they weren't going to give their sister to him. And they just say, I mean, they looked right. They's the children of Jacob. And they's the children of Israel. And then they said the right things. And they talked the right talk. And they walked the right walk. Amen. But at that point, all they was to the inhabitants of the land was just snakes in the grass. Amen. Yeah, Dinah shouldn't have married one of them. Amen. But they shouldn't have lied to keep her from it. Amen. They said, boys, if you'll take the mark that God put on them, you can have Dinah. The Bible said they went out and the Bible said they circumcised themselves. And they said, here we are. We're just like you Jews now. And the Bible said once they did that, amen, they was down there in their camp, and the children, amen, them boys went through there and they killed every one of them. Amen. They killed every one of them. You know what they was? They was just waiting. They was just waiting on them. Amen. They looked apart. I mean, they said all the right things. Amen. But what was they doing? They didn't even realize they was. But those people in the house of God, how they'll come in the church house, and they don't even realize they're the devil. But they're just like old Judas, and the devil's down inside of them. You better watch out for that. That snake that's hiding in your grass, he'll grab a hold of you. He'll grab a hold of you. Robert, get you a song if you would. I'm done. Amen. I know. Amen. I know tonight.